Hey everyone, thank you so much for coming to Lydia Joseph Dialogues. Today, it's a continuation of the video that I made last time. I had decided to merge this video with the last time video, but I realized that it's going to be too long and too boring. That's why I decided to split and have one showing my African-inspired living room decor. So if you haven't watched that video, kindly, after finishing this one, don't leave in the middle of this video. Watch to the end and then make sure that you go back and see how I have arranged my living room decor. And I mentioned that those pieces are something that I am selling. I am operating an online shop. And I'm targeting everyone who shops online. But most importantly, I was targeting people from outside Kenya. The name of my business is Jalini African Souvenirs. Usually, souvenirs are linked to travels. A souvenir is usually linked or connected to those holiday gift shop merchandise. And it's always an item that you pick for remembrance. Souvenir is a French name that means remembrance or memory. It's an item that a traveler picks so that they can remember the holiday experience that they had in the country that they picked the souvenirs. I know people always say that I can't finish a conversation without mentioning my dad. In my most recent video, I haven't mentioned him, but this time I have to because the whole souvenir biashara came from my dad because the business idea came from something that he did. He had gone to mission work in Samburu at a place called Tum. And while they were leaving, the Samburu women selling those products to them. And my dad never thought that he needed them because my mom can't wear. And he didn't think that anybody else could wear them. But a certain lady approached him and she told him that you don't necessarily pick necklaces for your wife or for your daughters. You can pick any item and keep it in your house so that it can always remind you of Tum, Samburu Tum. That's what he told me. And after that, he picked a gourd that he usually have back at home. And he also picked some pieces of necklaces, the one you can see in your screen. So my dad took this piece of necklace. These pieces are made by the Maasai and the Samburu, and the colors that I have are the main one, the red, black, and white. These are the colors that are associated with the Maasai and the Samburu. So this piece is special. That's how I got the necklace. And when he told me that story, I thought that one day I was going to come up with an African souvenir shop. And I was going to sell stuff to people so that they can take some pieces to their land and connect or make it a point of contact with Kenya. So constantly thinking about it because I have practically seen the power of mind bringing to reality whatever I had been thinking. It's called the power of mind. When you think about something consistently, somehow the world will do everything that it has to do to bring it to you. So that's how it started. And souvenir can be any item, not just decor. Also, you don't even have to buy a souvenir. You can pick it from nature. I have one of my sisters who travels a lot, and she has several collection of stones. She has water. There are so many things that you can pick from the places that you've been going. I have so many souvenirs that are a point of contact from all the places I have visited. I am just going to run all the pieces that we have. First of all, thank you so much because of your feedbacks. So many people have come to my inbox. So many people have called using the number that I provided last time, and they have really shown interest, especially to the African wall hangings. Those wall hangings have really attracted people. Wow, people are embracing African pieces. They are embracing African designs. They have seen that it's beautiful, especially when it is in your interior space. So we have several other wall hangings. We've got handmade vases. We have mats. We have all these shades. We also have several such African pieces in different sizes. These mats, this is an old piece, but there are several also in different colors. We are selling all types of accessories, like earrings, we are selling belts, we are selling bracelet, ankles. We have all kinds of accessories, and you can put your initials or whatever name that you want. We also have these baskets, and this is an unfinished product. You can customize with a piece of cloth. This is just one ribbon, but they are being customized also according to what you want. So this is unfinished, but it's already beautiful as it is. We have kitenges in several colors. So what you just do is to pick a piece that is going to... My light, this lighting is somehow poor. You just have to let us know the theme in your house so that we can put a piece of cloth that is close to that theme. These others are locally available material, but you're going to come up with such a piece which is a diamond. This is for my house, but we have several. This also is a piece of cloth. This basket here is a very nice basket where you can store your remote control. You know that if you have kids, remote control always get lost. So this is a nice piece to put your remote control. You can get a larger piece to put your fruits. It's also a multi-purpose piece for personal use. You can carry it like this, and these pieces are removable. You can remove this and carry it like that. It can be changed in so many ways. Like, this can also be a deco piece in your house. There are several ways of decorating your living room or whatever room with an African basket. This is called Kiondo. Kiondo is a Kikuyu name for basket. And you can replace your modern clutch bag with an African clutch bag. That's what I'm going African. So many things I am doing nowadays. This is a very small piece. I don't know, because of being very close in the camera, it shows as if it's big, but we have several pieces of small and medium and really, really small for your little girls. These two can also be a home decor. It can be a chondo. You just remove this part and this and the camber here, and you are left with that flower vase. And this one is so beautiful, and I love brown so much. This is my old piece, but we have several, as you can see in your screen. This is so old. By the way, these pieces are long lasting. That's another thing why I love custom made stuff. It's because they are long lasting. This one I have carried like over and over, and now it's old and still looking beautiful. But you see that I have changed studios. Before that, I was recording my videos in my living room, and I want to have a makeover one of these days. And one of the pieces that I want to use is this. There are several others actually so beautiful. I am planning to like redo everything in my house nowadays, because the designs are new and they are so nice and they are so unique. You feel like changing your room over and over, but I have to be disciplined, because you can't be taking everything that you're selling. So these are some of the pieces that we have at Jalin right now. these pieces. Remember, it's an online shop, so I usually go and tell them what to make. I like it when a client decides. If you have an African piece or a design that you have seen on Pinterest or you have seen somewhere, I am telling you that the talent that the people who are making all these pieces have, you guys, when you see how they are transforming locally available materials to come up with very beautiful stuff, you will know that they can do anything. There's someone who had posted a photo of an African map. It's always good to market whatever you're doing, like networking. I've networked and I have make known that there is such business. And one of those posts, somebody had asked, where can I get such a piece? And Wangeshi mentioned my name. Thank you so much, Wangeshi, because several ladies asked for my number, and out of those several, that is how online business work. Some people will ask, but they are not buying, but others are serious. And actually, I've come to realize that those who seems like they are not going to buy are the one who actually buy, because this lady, I don't know her, but we talked via Messenger and she actually got the piece. And she loved it. Network your things to strangers. That line have worked for me, like in everything that I'm doing. She loved this piece. And it was custom made. Something that you have seen and you don't know how to make it, bring it to Jalini. We are going to custom make for you. The business is still ongoing locally, albeit slowly, because we have limited movements, and so we are not able to move around very many places. So it's working only in Nairobi. If you are our client beyond Kenya, as you know, right now, the planes are immobile. Have you seen that picture where planes are like sleeping? At least we know that this shall come to pass, and the planes will be all over and we'll be able to travel again and do business again. That was initially what I really wanted. So let me just run all those pieces. Take care of your mental health. This too shall come to pass. Thank you so much for watching me. Until next time, bye.